So I'm gonna shut the door. It's a little dark, don't be afraid of the dark, kids. But what we're gonna do is I'm going to show you how I handle the eggs. Check this out, guys. How are you? This is a yellowfoot tortoise that we got from a zoo. And my goodness, as you can see, it's dug what's called a pallet. This is one of the animals that's a little bit deformed, but no worries, he's gonna live out here without a problem. Actually, I think it's a female, but I think it's interesting that it dug a little pallet inside this area. Now, why am I in Caiman Creek? That's why. She just heard me, she came out of her cave. It's time to talk about her eggs. She's still protecting the nest over there, even though the eggs that are in there were the damaged ones. If you remember from earlier this summer when I pulled them out, there were some cracked eggs. So she's a new mom. This is her first time building and laying eggs in a nest and protecting them. So I had to go in, grab the eggs, kind of get them out, and we're incubating them now. They should be hatching in a couple of weeks. And we're gonna do something exciting today. We're actually in, and I'm gonna show you how to candle your eggs. I don't know if you've ever heard this, but we're gonna candle some of the smooth front eggs and see if any are fertile, and I'll show you how to look for that. But anyway, I thought before we do that, we'd have a look around Caiman Creek. We'd see how she's doing right now. Of course, if I come over here, she's gonna come running out. She's definitely gonna come out when she hears me walk over by this nest. So here is her nest, okay? And it's looking pretty good. I don't know if she'll come out or not. But remember, we had those eggs that were kind of damaged. Let's see if I can find them. There's a little bit of a chamber in there. Definite chamber. I'm not feeling, here she comes. Here she comes. She's not happy. I'm not even gonna play, people. Because she'll come, I don't want her to get too stressed out. My gosh. Whew. All right, good mama, good. Whoa, that's a good jump, good mama. Settle down. I just kind of want to hang out and show people around a little bit. Let's clean my hand off a little bit. Here is one of the Podoc nemus unophilus. It's a female, large female here, doing just awesome. These turtles are fantastic. I don't think we see enough of them, to be perfectly honest. Now, when they're babies, they have just tons of tiny little spots on them. But look at how big this turtle is. And there's a species called Podoc nemus expansa, which is a huge river turtle from the Amazon, but that is the yellow spotted Amazon turtle. And then look at that, there's the tripricatus over here. She's keeping an eye on me. I don't know if I'm going to be able to get over there. Here is one of the Central American musk turtles, kind of right there. You guys can see it. I got to be careful of her. I don't want to get bit. Look at that. Yep, that's the male. Nice big male. All right, these will get a bit bigger. Stereotypus tripricatus. They even have a little hinge. See that? They got a hinge on there. So that's pretty awesome. We have that turtle doing well. Go ahead. So again, love being in here, but we're gonna get to these eggs in just a little bit. I gotta go inside, get in the incubator. I wanted to see the male. Just checking on everybody. This is what we do. There's the male unophilus, or Amazon spotted turtle. I don't know if you guys can see him down in there, but he's looking good. Kind of hard to see. He's got that camouflage. We planted a tree fern in here. We've got the goofy little tortoises, redfoots. We've got the leaf turtles. We've got the twist neck turtle here in the leaves, very happy. The other one lives just on the other side, so it's funny they climbed over. This one certainly did climb, and my gosh, that's kind of rad. And then how about Central American wood turtle? Awesome. This is the Ronoclemmie's manii, and maybe I'll make this a gift to our friend Blake because he does breed these. I don't know, or maybe I can get a couple of males. What do you think? What should I do? Should I get some males of this? It's kind of nice to have a Central American turtle in the Central South American enclosure, don't you guys think? Really cool, Ronoclemmie's. That's a nice turtle. I've actually seen Ronoclemmie's in Costa Rica, which was awesome to be able to see one out in the wild there. There's another goofy little yellowfoot. But okay, what do you say
Oops. What do you say? I head on inside and we pick this up where I am going to do a candling session. I'll show you just what I mean. Be right back.
Thank you to all our loyal Patreon members out there who have helped to create an amazing reptile community online with us. This week's shout out goes to longtime super fan, Sally Rutledge.
Okay, I am in the closet, my closet here. This is where I do voiceovers, where I have all my clothing, things like that. But we've got our eggs. We've got our Caiman eggs. And I'm going to show you guys what I mean by candling eggs. You want to find a dark area, which is my closet. So let's go ahead. We're going to shut the lights off because this is going to be, don't mind my dirty closet, okay? My wife probably not too happy I'm in here. But okay, so what we're going to do is we have to use the light on our old mobile phone. So I'm going to shut the door, okay? And I'm going to set you guys up. Oh, it's a little dark. Don't be afraid of the dark, kids. But what we're going to do is I'm going to show you how I candle the eggs. So we're going to lift the egg up. We don't rotate the egg. And we're going to just put the light up to the egg. Now, this egg does not look good. There doesn't seem to be anything in it. And it's been quite a few weeks since these eggs were laid. Can you guys see? It's been quite a few weeks. And you should see, to be honest, a big giant mass, okay? But this looks empty, sadly. So let's keep going. See what else we got here. Oh man, this one also doesn't look like it has much in it. Well, wait a minute now. Well, there might be something in there. But it should be further along. I don't know. I'm not convinced on that one. Bummer. All right. Here we got one that's expanding with the humidity. You can kind of see a thin. Now that. Look at that, my friends. Nice and dark. There's somebody in there. There is somebody in there. You know? So there is a solid egg, and what I like about it is it's expanding. The egg is growing. Okay, put that one in. Look at this, nothing. See that? You saw the difference between the two? That one you couldn't really see through. This one, I don't know. This one I'm not so sure about. I'm not rotating these eggs. Nah. Now, since she's a first-time mom, I wouldn't expect all these eggs to actually be fertile. But there you go. Two of them look to be fertile. So how cool is that? That's awesome. The two eggs look to be fertile. Let's get some light back on in here. Get you guys. We'll take a walk back to the incubator room. Get the light on. I use the sphagnum moss. I can keep it moist, which is what I've been doing. So we're keeping them moist. I'm gonna have to vacuum that, but we're keeping these guys nice and moist, but it looks like two of them are good. And hey, that's okay by me. I don't mind just two animals hatching. It's my first time ever hatching crocodilian eggs, so I'm hoping that it works out. Hey, what are you gonna do? You gotta take the good and the bad. We're learning things here, and hopefully she will become more fertile as she breeds more with this male. Clearly she's liking her habitat. There's nesting material in there, which is fantastic. That's what we want. We want that stuff to happen. Now we've got the rhino eggs. We have, of course, some radiated tortoise eggs right there. We've got one egg from our redfoot. So things are gonna be taking off here this season. Let me show you these, okay? These never got moldy. They're a little wrinkled, but again, we're getting close to the time when they're gonna hatch. So here's hoping that those rhino eggs prove out. All right, let's get these guys back in the incubator. And no worries, no drama. Here we go, right back in. Awesomeness, people. Pretty excited about that. I'm hoping it works out.
I'm gonna be home this fall, so I should hear the little ew, ew, and I'll be able to help them out of the eggs. Gonna be awesome. And they'll imprint on me, and I'll be mommy. Ah, just always wanted, I always wanted to be mommy to a bunch of little critters. Well, I guess I already am a mom, a dad, what are you gonna do? You know what I mean, crocodilians, man, how awesome is that? There you go, so good times here. Really appreciate each and every one of you for watching these videos and seeing what's going on here in my world. Lots happening this fall. Make sure you guys keep it right here at Kamp Kenan to see what crazy things I am going to be doing to this backyard. We're bringing it to a whole nother level. We're going to have, hopefully, two new smooth-front caimans. Maybe I got to build a nursery for them. Who knows? See you guys.